the 2K Sports Pregame Show.
Hello again, everybody. Welcome to the NBA Finals. I'm Ernie Johnson, proud to be with our friends Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith on 2K Sports, and we are getting primed and ready for Game 2. And the series tonight takes place in Oakland, where it'll be the Warriors going up against the Cleveland Cavaliers. Checking out Cleveland, an ugly showing for them to start the series as they were beaten handily. Still, it's just one game, and they look to return to form here in Game 2. And coming into Game 2 after dropping Game 1 of the Finals, do you think that they can come back in this series, Shaq, even if they don't even it up with a win tonight?
You know, I think if they lose this game, they can still win the series. However, the odds of them winning the series with a loss tonight, it drops dramatically.
Well, this is a game, Ernie, where they need to send a message. That's it. You know, it's not a must win, but they definitely need to get the momentum and change that. So you don't have to definitely win, but you have to send that message.
That will do it for us. Kevin Harlan standing by with the call. We will see you later on.
Continue. Just two teams remain. They are battling their way toward this title. Game two of the finals. This is Kevin Harlan with Greg Anthony and Clark Kellogg alongside. And our sideline reporter tonight is Doris Burke. We'll see the Cleveland Cavaliers facing the Golden State Warriors. Take a look at the Warriors. They hold a one-game lead in the series, looking to take two straight before going on the road.
And you've heard the adage, a playoff series doesn't start until someone wins on the road. I'm not so sure about that. I mean, as the top seed, all they have to do is take care of business on their home court. They did that in their last game. We'll see if that's the case again here tonight.
Yeah, and you talk about pressure. Winning this game would have them going on the road with very little pressure on them. Games 3 and 4 won't be nearly as nerve-wracking if they get it done here today.
Look at Cleveland's starting group. Kyrie Irving and J.R. Smith at the guard set. LeBron and Love with the talented pair at the forward position. And it's Thompson in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. Irving with the ball. They set the pick. Smith on the wing, covered by Barnes. Love with the screen on Barnes. Six on the shot clock. Another shot, and it's Love getting it to go.
He got a great read of where that miss was going, and that allowed him to be the first guy to it and get the putback.
Green with a screen for Curry. Down low, got a piece of it, and stolen by LeBron. Ball going up court, and Steph Curry with the foul. That's his first foul.
I mean, that's a tough break for the D. I mean, he took the hit and drew the whistle.
Yeah, but he was late to get there, Greg, so the referee couldn't give him a free pass on that one.
Thompson inside, covered by Bogut. So he gets the whistle, contact on the way up, and two shots coming up.
And with the offense getting right to the rim, at least they saved the layup.
Old school D right there, just telling them no easy layups. It's as simple as that. And that's what you expect from them.
Cleveland shooting their first free throws of the game. That free throw missing. He's good on the second. First quarter, about a minute and a half in. Outside Curry. That's good.
And his presence as a scorer, it just has a calming effect for the rest of the team. He's a fallback option whenever they need one.
Now here's LeBron. Love kicks to Irving. A screen from Thompson. Irving drives in, and he connects on the jumper. The screen did the trick. Irving's got his first bucket of the night.
And he came off that screen, and the D just didn't get over the top of it.
Yep, weren't there in time enough to challenge, Greg. And when that's the case, you can mark those up for him.
Now here's Thompson. Barnes can't get it to go.
Outstanding perimeter defense there. That was a well-contested shot.
Yeah, and you know he takes a lot of pride in his defense. There are no easy threes if he's on it.
In the corner, Irving with it. Love outside. Good, and the assist goes to Irving. Love's got 5 points so far.
They really can't allow him too many open looks like that. I mean, that's just inviting trouble.
Curry against Irving. Curry passes to Bogut. Back to Curry. Lock at six. Pass to Bogut. Pulls up on the wing, and he hits the jump shot. Thompson's got his first bucket in this one.
Really nice way to get your first bucket of the day.
Now it's ended down to Doris Burke, who was able to talk with head coach Teron Lue.
I asked him how he felt about his chances of taking game two on the road, and he told me, I still think we can. Our goal was to come in and take away at least one of these two games here, and we can still meet our goal. But this is the NBA Finals. Nothing comes easy. We'll see if they can meet their goal. Guys?
Thanks a lot, Doris. Some changes for Golden State. Spates comes in for Andrew Bogut. And it's Iguodala in for Barnes. James against Iguodala. And the whistle blows on the backcourt violation. He went over and back. And on the screen now is the 2K leaderboard with a rundown of this postseason's assist leaders. Fifth on the list, LeBron James.
And it seems like he's taking it on his shoulders to get every one of his teammates involved in the offense here in the postseason. What a passing display.
Now here's James. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for him. Irving against Curry. And the shot counts. He's fouled, and it's a chance for a three-point play.
Outstanding entry pass there. He knew exactly where to go with the ball.
And some changes here for the Warriors. Leandro Barbosa. He's checked in for Klay Thompson. And it's Livingston in for Curry. And the Cavaliers will go with a different look here. Mozgov, he's checked in for Tristan Thompson. Fry comes in for Kevin Love. Shumpert is checked in for J.R. Smith. And it's Matthew Dellavedova in for Irving. Here is Livingston. Now the dish to Green. Here's Barbosa. And a wide open look for Iguodala. And the Warriors miss again. Here's Dellavedova. The feed to Shumpert. And Fry kicks to LeBron. They find Jay on the way. Good. LeBron's got five.
This is as good as it gets for a first quarter in terms of shooting the basketball.
Greg, you're exactly right. I mean, everything seems to be dropping. Impressive scoring here.
Here is Livingston. Spates sets a screen. Here's Barbosa. Mozgov with the block. Dellavedova dishes to Mozgov. Mozgov sets a screen for Shumpert. Back to Mozgov. Iguodala with the steal. Shumpert against Barbosa. Livingston no luck. And here's Cleveland. They're on a 13-4 run. LeBron kicks to Fry. Here's Dellavedova, covered by Barbosa. James outside. Dellavedova from outside. And it's Spates with the rebound. Warriors trail by six. Here's Barbosa. That falls. Nice feed that time from Andre Iguodala.
And I like how he puts himself in position there to finish on the break.
Yeah, you know, that's what we call seeing and feeling the game. Excellent read of how that play was going to develop and where the ball was going. That's stuff that you oftentimes can't teach, Brett.
And yes, sir, that one drops.
You know, as soon as he recognized the height mismatch, he immediately pulled up for the jumper.
And, Greg, that's just good basketball. Come on, good basketball there. Clean look from that range. He's got to take it.
Green with a screen on James. Back to Iguodala. Spates sets a screen. Outside, Green. Hits it from three-point range. Green's got his first 3 points of the game.
That feed by Iguodala. Really good example of his passing ability.
James. That misses, would have counted had it gone in. And still a close game as the first quarter comes to a close. Cavaliers ahead, up by three. And back in a moment as we'll get underway with quarter number two. Chance to hear from LeBron James as he talked about the challenge of remaining calm and collected throughout the ups and downs of the NBA season.
For me, at a younger age, I was never even keel. We would win a playoff game when I was younger. I was excited out of my mind, and then you would lose, and I was the worst person in the world. But I think at this point in my career, I kind of stay even. One game shouldn't affect the next game. You know, you go out and play as hard as you can, live with the results.
Again, just another part of the maturation process for LeBron. He's become such the consummate pro.
Yeah, he really has been. It's amazing to see the pressure he's dealt with and the way he's handled it with that even-keeled nature. You know, he's as solid and steady as they come at this point in his career. Nothing phases him. Nothing rattles him.
It's the NBA playoffs. Thanks for joining us as we get back to the action here in this game two. What stands out to you from the Cavaliers in this one?
They've won the effort battle, and that's allowed them to control the backcourt.
And it's been gang rebounds. I mean, everybody has done a sublime stuff, guys. Absolutely sublime.
Clark, he's going to start putting on a show now.
And that's usually how it goes. Once they get that lead, it's almost like they give him free reign.
That Kia Slam Cam replay really gave you a good look at the action. Thompson outside. Barnes against Smith. And that one goes in as he is fouled. It'll be 3 points if he converts at the line.
And that's just showing off right there, guys. I mean, he is too good with that crossover.
The Warriors shooting their first foul shot of the night.
At the line of Warriors, Harrison Barnes. With one.
One shot. Mind the lanes. Mind the lanes. One shot.
That's good from Barnes. Cavaliers leading. And we're starting the second quarter, about a minute gone. Here's Irving, and it's sent back by Bogut. Thompson outside. Curry attacking. The shot will not go. Cavaliers shooting has been outstanding in this game at 58%. J.R. Smith on the wing, covered by Barnes. And off there, he misses his first shot of the night. The Warriors have gone 1-of-3 to start out the second quarter. Thompson passes to Curry. Thompson against Love. The score now all even. Thompson's got his second bucket of the night. Cleveland with the ball. They are still stinging from the loss on Thursday.
And talk about a team that just never seemed to get into a rhythm offensively. It was just an ugly game to watch.
Yeah, that's an understatement. I mean, they didn't appear to have any kind of cohesiveness in terms of game plan. And they never figured out how to attack the defense in that.
Back to Curry. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact, and he'll shoot two.
That's his first personal foul.
The Warriors have gone 1-for-1, making their previous attempt at the line.
At the line for two.
And they now lead as the free throw drops for him. And in rush, he's checked in for Golden State. And both free throws good for Curry.
He has such terrific form and consistency on his free throws. Beautiful to watch.
Smith outside. Quarter two and just under 2.5 minutes gone by. And Tristan Thompson gets the whistle that time. That's his first foul. And that's good for two.
First personal foul, team's third.
Warriors have gone 2-for-4 shooting the ball here in the second. Curry against Irving. Curry dishes to Bogut. That drops. Bogut's got his first basket of the night.
There it is again. On a lot of their possessions this first half, they've established great position inside.
Yeah, just getting the ball into the post has to be option number one for them right now.
It's a pick by Love. Feeds to Smith. He dishes it to Thompson. Five on the clock.
And that's foul number two. And maybe you don't sit him at this point, but you really have to be careful to not pick up another before half.
And the Warriors making a change here. Green's checked in. Channing Frye's checked in for Cleveland. James comes in for Matthew Dellavedova. Passes it to Smith. It's deflected. Rush with the steal. Irving against Curry. Bounces high off the rim and drops. Now it's a 4-point Warrior lead.
They've done a great job of getting into the middle of that defense and scoring in the paint.
And that's why they're on this run. You get that close to the hoop, and it's a lot easier to make shots.
The try by James. It's stolen by Green. Outside Curry. Dishes to Thompson. And a great assist by Curry as that one goes in. Curry's got his fourth assist in this one. And a closer look here at the hustle stats for the Warriors.
Boy, they've really amped up the pressure at the defensive end, guys, and have piled up the steals in the early going.
Yeah, and one thing, Clark, I've noticed is how quick their hands have been tonight. Thanks to that, they've gotten a lot of points off of turnover.
You know, next time he has that much space, he should just go straight up with it and leave the fadeaway at home. Park that fadeaway. Take the shot that's available.
And Rush kicks to Thompson. Green with a screen on Smith. Thompson passes to Green. And it's blocked. LeBron against Thompson. The try by James. Cleveland moving it around. Smith right side. Warriors with the rebound. Outside Curry. Over in the corner, Barnes. Makes it off the glass. Barnes has got 7 points for the quarter.
Some defensive breakdowns are starting to show up now. Their last four buckets allowed have come from very close range.
Yeah, high percentage shots are what they are getting in terms of the attempts, and that's just not going to get it done. They've got to figure it out.
No good from Frye.
Kevin, I didn't like that defensive effort at all, but they're lucky he missed it.
Yeah, you hope that's not indicative of the type of D they're going to play, because if they do, they're going to have struggles with him tonight.
He hit a three in the first, but so far has been unable to capitalize here in this quarter.
2 seconds separating the shot clock and game clock. Back to Irving. Six to shoot. LeBron outside. Can't hit the turnaround jumper.
Boy, that's a warm-up jumper there. I mean, when you're a pro, you can't make excuses for missing that one.
And that concludes the first half. The Warriors on top. They finish off the second quarter on a 15-4 run. And time now to go courtside as we send you over to Doris Burke from the sideline. Doris?
Guys, I'm here with Stephen Curry. And Steph, coach made a point of stating how important the physical presence would be in this game. How important is that going to be for the team in the second half?
That's a big deal. I mean, just being physical and, make the right plays, and then hopefully put ourselves in a good position to win.
You've got to match that opponent's intensity, Steph. Thanks for the time. Guys?
Okay, Doris, much appreciated. And now for halftime. So we'll be back in just a bit to get the third quarter underway.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello again, everybody. Ernie Johnson, Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny the Jet Smith. The NBA playoff energy is in the air, and we're halfway through this game. Well, for the Warriors, they came in playing with a purpose. Even though it's early in this championship series, they can smell blood in the water, hoping to go up 2-0 by the end of the night. Taking a look at the Warriors, Kenny, what'd you think?
Well, they forced their way to some easy buckets, aggressively going to the rack, imposing their will. I mean, taking it inside establishes an attitude and toughness that you can't get any other way.
Shaq, how do you think Cleveland played?
You know, two things went on in the first half. Yes, we saw good offense take advantage of mediocre defense, but we also saw a motivated team take advantage of a team that didn't want to hustle. They need an attitude adjustment.
Just about time for the third quarter to get underway, and we'll see you again at the horn.
Welcome back to our coverage of the NBA Finals. More action straight ahead. One of the stories here, Harrison Barnes getting it done today.
Yeah, he was in attack mode from the word go. Came out very aggressively in that first half.
Take a look at his shot chart. It looks like the ink spilled right at the rim. No reason for him to settle for anything less.
The defensive stalwarts, Green and Bogut, are down low. The Splash Brothers are the guards. And it's Barnes in at the three spot. So that's the group out there for Golden State.
And the D does just enough to throw off his rhythm on that shot. And when the size advantage is as big as it was there, I mean, that's exactly what he's supposed to do in that situation.
Curry dishes to Green. He kicks it to Thompson. Green with a screen for Thompson. Back to Green. High post shot. Cavaliers with the rebound. Love's got three rebounds now in this one. Clark, some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, they need a basket just to regain some momentum here, Kevin. That's their third straight make off an assist.
Great ball movement.
The Warriors leading. Outside Curry. On the wing, Thompson. Here's Bogut. Right through the D for the layup. Bogut's got his second bucket of the night.
Finally, they get one to drop. That's one of their first four here in the third.
The Cavaliers trail by four. And we're just about a minute and a half into the third quarter of basketball. A nice shot by Irving.
Nothing but money for him to start the half. They've made all three of their shot attempts.
Peek at the 2K leaderboard with the list of the top rebounders in this year's playoffs. Fifth is Draymond Green.
He's dialed up his rebounding here in the postseason. There's something about the big games that bring out the best in him.
Andre Iguodala is checked in for the Warriors. Livingston comes in for Steph Curry. Cleveland also making some changes. Mozgov, he's checked in for Love. Iman Shumpert has come in for Smith. And it's Matthew Dellavedova in for Kyrie Irving. Over a minute and a half into the third quarter of action. The drive by Thompson. Mozgov with the block. And that'll be Golden State as it goes out of bounds. Warriors retain possession. Ian Clark's checked in for Thompson.
Ian Clark.
Green, the screen. Here's Clark. That's tipped. Over to the wing. Dellavedova can't hit.
Even with that miss, they're shooting 75% coming out of the break. That's a strong start to the half.
Screen by Bogut. Bogut with a screen on Shumpert. Livingston kicks to Bogut. A tad short, but it's good off the front iron. Bogut's got 4 points now in the quarter.
You can't afford to get him that kind of a look.
Well, you know, he came off a good screen, but still, as a defender, you got to do a better job of fighting over and through that.
Iguodala with the steal. And now here comes Iguodala leading the break. Here's Green. Good D by LeBron.
And typically, he has the touch to finish when he's in tight, but not sure on that possession.
Outside jumper. For the tie, once again off the mark by Cleveland. Warriors leading by three. Bogut the pass to Iguodala. Bogut dishes to Iguodala. Bogut sends a screen for Iguodala. Shot clock at five. Here's Clark. And the Warriors get it back, and Green gets it to go.
Just a grinder, always doing the dirty work on the offensive glass, and that's one of the things he brings to the table.
The screen from Thompson. Dellavedova kicks to Thompson.
And guys, that's one of the more basic plays in anybody's playbook, but not to mention also truly one of the best.
And Greg, the pick frees him up, and Clark, the dunk, caps it off.
Well, you know, for me, guys, it's all about positioning and anticipation on those screen plays, and they got it right there.
Pass to Livingston. He feeds it to Clark. His three-pointer is off the mark. The Cavaliers trail by three. And there's the pass to LeBron. Out of bounds, Golden State takes possession.
I tell you what, he clearly had a brain freeze on that one. You might just as well keep going straight to the bench.
And the Warriors with some changes. Azili's checked in for Bogut. Spates comes in for Draymond Green. And it's Barbosa in for Ian Clark. And Cleveland with a change here, too. Prize checked in. Warriors leading by three. Iguodala kicks to Azili. They set the pick. Off the pick. And Spates gets it to go. Spates has got his first 2 points of the night.
That was an outstanding pick that gave him the room to bury the jump shot. Underrated, but not undervalued.
The drive by James. Mozgov's shot is off.
And you can see the defenders afraid to kind of get in his way a lot of times when he's on his way to the basket. But on that one, they were there.
From deep, Iguodala. And it's good. Assisting on the play was Livingston. And now it's an 8-point Warrior lead.
Nice stroke from long range. And if he keeps getting those opportunities, he better take them.
Dellavedova kicks to Mozgov. Now the Warriors moving it up. Here's Iguodala. And the lead now, double digits on that bucket. Iguodala's got 5 points now this quarter. And a moment here to take a look at some hustle stats for the Warriors.
The activity level defensively, I've really been impressed with. There's been an attack mode on the defensive end.
They haven't wasted time getting the ball up the court tonight either, and it's resulted in a lot of fast break points.
Here's Mozgov. once again off the mark by Cleveland.
And it's the Warriors' ball.
They're on a 13-5 run here. Livingston passes to Iguodala. Another three for Golden State.
Seems that every pass they make is leading to a score here. I mean, that's just exquisite ball movement.
And that's because the ball is looking for the best shot, and it's really paid off for them during the run.
Iguodala against LeBron, four on the shot clock. Dellavedova from outside. The long distance three is buried. Dellavedova has got himself going with the triple, his first basket of the game. And here at the end of the third quarter, it's a double-digit ball game. Warriors lead by 10. And we'll be back right after this. Here's LeBron. All right, now a chance to set the floor courtesy of Gatorade. Fourth quarter action, all fueled up and ready to go. On the court for Cleveland, LeBron and Love are the talented pair at the forward position. Kyrie Irving and J.R. Smith at the guard set. And it's Thompson in at the five.
Yeah, the defender all over.
Greg, he got him good there. I mean, that's why the shot was so far off.
At the line for the Warriors, Kevin Love taking two shots.
The first one falls. Andrew Bogut checked in for the Warriors. That misses, so he splits the free throws. Warriors leading by 9. And Thompson kicks to Curry. Barnes dishes to Green. On the wing, Thompson. He's covered by Irving. He's whistled for the 5-second back-to-the-basket violation.
And really, he played mistake-free basketball up to that point. That's the only time he's turned it over so far.
The Cavaliers trail by 9. Smith outside. Tipped away. The screen from Thompson. Kicks it to James. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Yes, and it's Smith with the assist that time. And it's 9 points for LeBron.
Boy, really nice job to take what the defense was giving him there.
Pass to Green. Smith outside. The dish to Irving. Jacks up a 3. Another 3 for Cleveland.
And they'll be counting on even more points from him. That's essential if they're going to pull this game out.
Curry passes to Green. And Thompson kicks to Green. And stolen by Love. Smith with it. Guarded now by Barnes. Just about 1.5 minutes gone by here in the fourth. 6 on the shot clock. It's a pick by Love. James, no good.
That's a shot he's got to hit. You don't get many looks better from that range.
Barnes dishes to Curry. Now here's Barnes from deep. Green. The shot is off. Good D from Love. Smith against Barnes. Smith the pass to Irving. The feed to Love. Takes it from 10. And Cleveland again with the bucket.
And that's another assist for a team that is putting on a clinic on how to share the ball.
And I love the mentality that they've had. If a shot isn't there, they're not forcing it. They're moving it side to side until they finally get the one they want. Just not happy with how his team is playing, and they just have been on the wrong side of this run.
Yeah, and you know what, Greg? Sometimes just a pause in the action, which is what a timeout can give you, is enough to change things around.
And I think Doris Burke has something for us right now. Doris?
Thanks, guys. I got a chance to hear what Steve Kerr was saying to the team. He told them, this is it, fellas. Let's hit them right out of this timeout. Put some pressure on them. Show them how much you want it. Let's go get it. Guys, he's really exhorting them to give them a burst of energy.
Clearly a foul.
Yeah, he took a shot there. Earned those free throws.
And now we'll get a perspective here on the hustle game, how it's been going for the Cavaliers.
Contested shots and block shots. They're bread and butter defensively. They're giving up no easy looks.
Yeah, and also the way they've been able to generate points off of the turnovers that they forced tonight has also helped.
Good on the second free throw. Just over 2.5 minutes played now here in the final quarter of regulation. LeBron outside. It's a pick by Love. That's a two from Smith. Good, and the assist goes to James. James has got 3 assists in the game.
Well, they left it until the fourth quarter, but finally, the run they needed to get back into this.
I didn't think it was going to happen for them, quite honestly, but they finally turned it on, turned it up a little bit. Now they've got to come up with some stops.
Smith drives in, and he gets contact and the whistle on the shot. 2 shots coming up.
Good game for Irving. He has 8 points, and he's hit the mark twice from three-point range as well.
And Clark, it's no stretch to say the more points he gives them from beyond the arc, the better off they'll be.
That one drops. He ties it up. So they now lead by one. The Warriors shooting at 50% in a decent groove. Curry kicks to Green. Thompson against Smith. Thompson dishes to Green. And he finishes nicely on the way.
Loose D here. Critical stretch. I mean, you better off sending him to the free throw lines and have him get that good a look.
Feeds it to Smith for three. Offensive rebound.
I'm shocked that didn't turn into 3 points. I mean, he makes you pay on those nearly every time.
Curry outside. Good D by Irving.
Good little two-man action there, but they just can't get the shot to fall.
Yeah, but that was a beauty. Good-looking shot, well-executed play. I wouldn't be surprised to see them go back to it. He shot the ball exceptionally well as they built this lead for themselves here.
The Warriors making a switch here. Iguodala's checked in.
They didn't shoot it well from the line in the first half, but they've turned it around here, and it's helped them secure the lead. I mean, free throw shooting is important when you're trying to pad a lead.
Green in the post. He's going up against Love. Screen by Bogut. Green with a screen on Irving. Just 5 on the clock. Thompson with it. Picked up by Love. Moves back up. So the whistle blows on the shot, and 2 free throws for the contact right there.
At the line for your Warriors, Draymond Green. At the line for two,
Okay, gentlemen, two shots. Two shots.
He hits the first one, and that narrows the gap to one.
Take a look at what Green's done. He has 8 points, and he's put 1 3-pointer on the board.
You know what, though, Clark? It wouldn't be a bad idea going forward to try to let him do a little more damage from beyond the arc.
And both free throws good for Green.
Nicely done. Without much separating these teams, that's when you have to make good at the line.
And a wide open look for James. That's in, coming off the assist from Thompson. And that's now 11 points for LeBron.
Hard to imagine them losing this game if they can keep shooting like that.
Not many empty trips for this group. It seems everything's falling for them this half.
And here are the Warriors now. Outside Curry. He dishes it to Thompson. Bogut with a screen on Smith. Thompson passes to Green. Off target from outside.
Well, he had 1 3-pointer in the first half, but so far in the second, he's come up with goose egg.
Thompson. Excellent D here by Iguodala. Golden State's gone 0-3 so far in the fourth quarter from long range. Green with a screen on Smith. Smith against Curry. Lock at six. Stolen by Thompson. And I think we'll see them burn the clock a bit here.
You know, I think that's probably a smart move.
I think so, too.
Irving, good!
Kyrie Irving has simply caught fire.
Assisted by J.R. Smith. Timeout for Golden State.
Okay, fans, put your hands together for your Warriors girls! Let's get up and get down!
.32 seconds left in the fourth quarter. It's good! And he has brought them to within 2 points.
What a bucket at one of the more crucial moments of the game.
How about the cool, collected way in which he delivered it? Clutch!
And Thompson kicks to James. Back to Thompson. Irving dishes to LeBron. Warriors with the rebound.
And that's the shot he has to take.
Exactly. That's the right look. The decision was good. He just didn't execute.
Okay, man. Put your hands together. Warriors,
now Curry. Green, the screen. It's Curry with the drive.
Yes!
And tie game. That is a huge basket right there.
You know, the defense has got to do a much better job of fighting over those screens.
And, Greg, especially when the ball is in his hands. I mean, come on now. You know he doesn't miss too many open looks like that.
Let's keep it going for your Warriors, girl.
Here's Irving.
Got it! He got it!
Just in time!
What a shot!
As big a shot as you'll ever see.
And on the biggest stage in basketball. What a moment in the finals.
So it's a narrow win for the Cavaliers, pulling it out. Just a massive victory, Greg. Maybe it's overstating it, but I think this was a game they had to have.
And I don't think it's overstating it. I agree with you. I mean, going down 2-0 would have given this team a huge hill to climb. But now at one game apiece and with some momentum, this is anybody's series.
And now we'll send it down to Doris Burke, who's standing by courtside.
LeBron, you have exercised some demons in this building, but this is a proud team. What will it take to beat them in the next game?
Well, I mean, it's a championship caliber team, and we're not going to celebrate about this win. We had to win this game. We wanted to win this game. It's a good win for us, but we look forward to the challenge.
Thank you for the time, sir. Guys, back to you.
Thank you, Doris. Great interview once again. That concludes Game 2 of the NBA Finals. This is Kevin Harlan thanking you for watching. And as the fans file out of the building, now time to head over to Ernie Johnson, Shaquille O'Neal, and Kenny the Jet Smith for the postgame show.
The 2K Sports postgame show.
Ernie Johnson here again with Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny Smith. Without further ado, let's present to you our Jordan player of the game, Kyrie Irving. It was one of those performances capped off with a game-winning shot that we'll be seeing on the highlights for quite a while. And Shaq, I can tell you want to say something. Your comments?
This series was in danger of getting away from them, but he just would not let it fall into a two-game hole. He pumped new life into the season by leading them tonight to even the series. This kid is woo-wee.
He was dead on from the field tonight, guys. I'd call his performance economical because there was no wasted opportunities. He took advantage of every good look he got. I mean, everything he put up was going in.
And that'll do it for tonight's NBA Finals coverage. For Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith, I'm Ernie Johnson. We'll see you for more high-stakes NBA Finals action coming up soon.